going on, guys? Doing another ICTV 75 detection, saws only, no assets, blah blah. You know, the whole shebang. Stealth. This time I'm gonna hit Shadow Raid really quickly. Sadly, as you can probably notice by lack of it in the title and lack of it in the description, no, I could not get all the loot. It was saddening. It was a big bummer. However, I did get, I did get a little bit of extra loot. There's a bit of an unfortunate mishap kind of towards the end of the video. But we do make it out of the heist in stealth, so that's all that matters. Overall, I found this to be significantly easier than Framing Frame was. It was the previous one of these stealth runs that I did. Of course, I checked down there just a few seconds ago to see if the guard was down there in front of that door. He wasn't, which is awesome. I actually, I really like that spawn. Just kind of checking things out. Guard and a sieve there. So we'll poke back into this room real fast. It should be safe to move right about now. Go ahead and start picking the door. Try to keep my eye on the sieve. And I believe right as I finish, yeah, I managed to get behind the boxes though and just kind of circle around it and stay out of his line of sight. Almost got caught by that guard. He was seeing me through the crack in the door. Of course, the murky water guards have a bit more health than standard guards, so I can't just kill him in a melee hit or two in order to knock him off to the side. I don't want to use my saw to kill him just in case. Even though it is a silent saw and it can only be heard in the radius, it's much safer, if not a bit longer, just to do it with the melee. So that's fine. Bit unfortunate, though, because as I kill him, he falls in the wrong direction, and I had to waste a body bag on him anyway. I would have just left him in his dominated state, but I'm pretty sure someone would have seen him if they walked by the door. So, I'm just going to go ahead and start moving some loot outside onto the balcony, except there's a guard there, so not really. Decided to go back through this room and pick open this door. Even though it allows guards to path up and down the catwalk outside and go through both of those open doors, I wasn't too concerned about it because I was only going to be up here for a few minutes anyway whilst I emptied out the loot on the top floor. Anything could be on that server. Maybe the president's email address. Found one. Of course, you have to be careful as you're edging along this wall because guards will see you on the top and they'll spot you pretty quickly. So I tried to be careful of that. I just tossed my bags just right over the side, kind of down behind those tires. And generally, it works out pretty well. I think I kind of mess up one bag here in a minute. It might be this Coke bag, actually. No, it was the bag I just threw down. Never mind. They kind of landed on top of the tires, so I was a bit concerned. Like, oh, guard might see them. Almost got detected. I don't know why I didn't. It was probably at like 99.9999999% detection. But I managed to get in cover just soon enough to not get detected, so that was nice. Somehow I didn't get detected by that guy either. I'm guessing he must have, like, turned away at the last possible second. I know sometimes I was trying to use Sixth Sense to detect people below me so they wouldn't be in range of my saw. They weren't. Managed to get it open. The guard outside was, of course, seeing the Coke bag that's on top of the... Or I assume the Coke bag that was on top of the tires. But I'm assuming what the guard done a minute ago, right when I was almost detected, was, you know, sometimes guards will get to a position and then had to lay down an ECM jammer here. Didn't want to waste it, but That's why I have them, is to cover situations like this. So, anyway, guards will sometimes move to a position, stand in place, turn, then turn directly back around and walk in the direction that they were just coming from. My best guess is that the guard might have just frozen place, turned around, and then turned back around and continued the way he was going. I left that artifact behind because my ECM general was going to quit, and I really didn't want to burn both of them just waiting on this guy, so I left the artifact up there for the time being. Managed to melee him, didn't want to risk him shooting to try to dominate him or anything like that, so. Probably just old batteries in this thing. Of course, over the intercom, you can hear the helicopter start to come by. Or you can hear that the announcement for the helicopter. So I kind of tried to peek up and see if it was going to be carrying the big loot box or not. You can hear the helicopter, and all it had for me was more guards. So I was a bit bummed about that. That was going to make getting things on the floor of the warehouse a bit more difficult. However, I probably wasn't going to be able to get the artifact anyway. The one that it drops off in the middle of the loot yard. Maybe I could. No, I don't know. I've honestly never seen an ICTV 75 stealth detection run for this heist. Not because they don't exist. I'm sure plenty of them exist, and I'm sure there's bunches and bunches and bunches of them before mine. However, I've just never actually taken the time to sit down and watch one all the way through or to see if anybody's went to get that piece of loot out of the middle of the yard. I'm sure if I was patient enough and just picked my timing really well, no coke bag in the basement, I'd be able to get to the artifact and, you know, pull it along and be able to maybe get it to the van. However, I didn't even get the chance to. So, I just got a bunch of guards instead, which was lame, but we managed. Got an artifact right here. Pretty convenient artifact, considering I don't really have to lug it all that far before I throw it down into the sewers. I wanted to see if this guard was going to walk in right as I was trying to throw it.
Guard, careful.
At this point, I already have a decent number of bags. I have an artifact and a weapon over here, and then I have several bags collected over on the far side where I had pulled them from upstairs. There was a pretty decent number of bags. Right off the top of my head, there was a bag of gold, there was the painting, there was a server, there's a coke bag, and the weapons, I believe. So that's, I think at this point I should be up to 7 bags. Unless I'm forgetting one and miscounting something, in which case, forgive me. I mean, I suppose I could scroll the video back and look, but that would mess up the post commentary. So.
Watch out, guard.
Of course, just kind of biding my time. All these guys are just filing out from upstairs, having just come from the roof, I suppose. Try to find the coke bag in here, however I didn't see it, and it wasn't on top of the air ventilation thing on the outside, so I was a bit perplexed. It almost usually spawns, but I went in here to see if this money bag spawned next to the computer, and in fact it did. So I went ahead and grabbed it. That's used bank notes from our allies overseas. Didn't see anything in that cage. Almost got detected there, almost got detected here. Thankfully that guard, who was in the locker room, decided to go out that direction as opposed to coming out the direction he was originally heading. Otherwise, I probably would have been in a bit of a pickle.
Guard.
So I lucked out there. Quite a bit. Another guard coming through.
Watch out. Guard.
Two. Sorry.
Guard.
I'm going to go ahead and proceed into the floor, the main floor. We'll get a money bag coke. Never mind. Some coke out of here. Run across the way and check these other crates. No money bag underneath the boxes. There's a money bag in that crate, I believe. Yeah, coke in that crate, and I don't think there was anything in this one. So a bit of an unfortunate note. That guard that you just saw, who to the left, who was looking at the, who was just kind of stationed there, that guard actually turned out to be, how did I make that without getting detected? That's pretty cool. Anyway. Yeah, the guard that was standing there just a minute ago as I was cracking open that third crate was actually stationary, so I never did get to go and get the two crates, one that's in front of the truck and one that's kind of beside the forklift, because that guard was going to see me no matter what I did, and I just really didn't feel like taking the time to try to kill him and then risk him being seen, being dominated while I was trying to beat him to death with my saw. So I just decided to leave those two crates alone. At least later towards the tail end of the heist when I was going to try to come back in and get some extra stuff. I think at this point I did go try to investigate, but he was still there, which wasn't unusual. I was thinking, okay, he's just taking a long time to move. But I come back several minutes later, and it does turn out that he hadn't moved whatsoever. So, no weapons on the rack. So, yeah, see, I couldn't get to the forklift one, and I was definitely sure I wasn't going to be able to get to the one in front of the truck. So I decided to go ahead and go down here and throw the bags underneath the grate so that I could move them. Of course, there was no guard in front of the basement door earlier, which made this possible. Otherwise, we would have had to kill that guard. Waste a pager on him. Definitely glad that little trick is included on the grates. I'm assuming that it's purposeful. so you don't have to use the thermal paste to get through any of these. You can just toss the bags under. I mean, it's a really common, well-known trick, but it's just one of the things I appreciate about this heist as a stealth heist. One of those little attention to details that is cool, makes the mission more fun and convenient, and less of a bag-moving simulator. Of course, there is the section coming up here in a few minutes where it's an absolute, I don't know, it's like, gosh, 5 to 7 minutes of just moving bags. I realize I don't need to pick that door in order to try to get outside. I just need to go back down through the basement. But yeah, I think I talked about it in my level zero stealth run for this heist. I really enjoy this heist as a stealth heist. I think it's one of the better designed stealth heists in the game, if not the best one. If it's not one of the best, then it's definitely one of my favorites. Have to check up there pretty frequently for guards who might be looking down at me. Of course, that almost happened right then. Had to walk all the way along the edge of the wall on that little, that strange little lip. I'm not even sure why the lip is there, if it's there for cosmetic purposes or not, but it turns out to be really useful for me here in a second. Helps my bag moving significantly. So what I decided to do is just, you know, throw the bags over, hug them against the wall so that no one can see them. So I just kind of hop off the ladder onto the thing, onto the little lip, or whatever you want to call it, and then just toss the bags. Of course, can't do that with the artifact because I can't throw it that far, so I just do it with the money and the coke. But it ends up working really nicely. In retrospect, I probably didn't need to climb up the ladder to do that. I probably just could have turned around and done it. But I wanted to get it as close to the wall as possible. And wanted to be able to see if a guard was looking down towards me so that I'd know if I threw the bag, they might see it fly through the air. So, managed to get the assault rifles up there without any troubles or woes.
Watch out.
And this guy started to come up here. Got pretty close to being detected. Would have definitely been an issue. Because then I probably would have had to lay down my jammer, hope he didn't shoot me. Then run across to the ladder, jump over onto the roof, and then jump down and try to dominate him, which probably wasn't going to happen. Or I wouldn't have been able to dominate him on the spot. I probably would have had to melee hit him at least once, and then dominate him, all before he ever shot me. Or before the ECM ran out. and I'm sure that just wasn't going to happen. So, thankfully, I just didn't get detected and didn't have to worry about it. Of course, making sure to hug this wall as I'm moving these bags, just so I don't accidentally walk in the way of some knucklehead's field of view. Of course, this part marks the beginning of the absolutely the terrible bag moving section, where I just mostly move all of these. I was counting them as I was moving them, and came to the conclusion that, including this artifact down here, I did in fact have 12 bags, so I could complete the heist if I wanted to or if I needed to, which is why I started to move all these things towards the van. In case later on down the heist also just found out, while I was doing this heist, that apparently you can climb up ladders sideways. I actually didn't know that. Anyway, thankfully that guy walked down there and had enough time to kind of shimmy across the top next to the railing before he turned. So, but yeah, this bag moving section is pretty asinine, honestly. It takes up a good portion of the video, I'm not going to lie. Mostly because since I'm in the ICTV and I'm trying to be careful about guards seeing, looking at me down from the alley, which is why you'll see me walking backwards here through this section a lot, or running backwards. I actually really enjoy having that skill in stealth, parkour aced, if I'm not mistaken, being able to, less for the actual sprinting sideways and backwards, and more for the application of crouch jumping in any direction I choose. Sometimes it's extremely beneficial just to be able to crouch jump. Like if I crouch jump from cover to cover, and then I get myself in a situation and the best way out is to crouch jump back, then I can do so without having to waste time turning around and potentially getting stuck on something. I've actually given light consideration into putting it into some loud builds, but I mean the points that it costs me to pick it up just wouldn't suit well for some of the heavily optimized builds that I use for my one down solo stuff, considering those are very point intensive and I usually pick them dry. So of course I just keep watching the roof for as long as I need to, so I'll see a guard as he comes over so I can get myself into a better hiding position so I don't get detected. And like I said, the only reason I'm doing all this bag moving now instead of more towards the end of the heist is simply because I want to go ahead and get the 12 bags in so I have the ability to escape if I want to without having to move all the bags if I, you know, got into trouble and I didn't just lose the run. So can't remember if it's right here. Yeah, it's right here. The guard was actually up on the roof, and I had to kind of chill out for a second and wait for him to leave.
Guard, be careful.
Of course, at this time I was also thinking about when I was going to go back up to the top floor and get that artifact I had to leave behind forever ago. I definitely wanted to get it because it's worth a lot of money and it's a nice piece of loot to get. I should have got it earlier, except I, you know, had thrown my bags in a kind of weird spot instead of behind the tires. One of them landed on top of the tire, and then, of course, that caused the guard to see and, you know, prevented me from getting it way earlier. So I do go back and get it after I go through and move all of this stuff. One of the interesting adjustments that I've had to make as I've started doing these stealths is I've realized how not really how slow ICTV is, because actually it doesn't feel slow once you wear it for so long, but how fast you feel when you're in a suit. It's crazy. Like, I went from doing this to, I think I was doing a, I think right after this I started working on my Birth of Sky one down solo again. And, like, one of the first things I noticed when I was doing the, started doing that run and was just kind of, you know, testing some more things out or whatever, was how quickly I moved while I was in the suit, and I almost had to just take a few moments to kind of readjust to how quickly I was moving, just because I had been doing so many of these. I've been working on a few different stealth heists. I kind of tried this one in between some others. Usually if I do a run, it's like my process that I've started doing so I don't burn myself out trying to do a certain challenge. You know, I'll do it a certain number of times until I, well, usually if I start feeling tired of it, I'll just immediately quit and I'll either take a break from the game or just, you know, go do whatever for a little while. But usually the first run I never assume is going to be a success. I always use it as experimentation and just to kind of get a feel for what I'm doing, especially something like this where I haven't done many of these stealths before, and this is really kind of a new thing to me, using these 75 detection, you know, using all these limitations on myself. The level 0 stealth was kind of a little warm-up to it, kind of like a prelude, but regardless. So then, usually the second run is the serious run, and I really do try to, I mean, I try to succeed on the first run, but if the first run doesn't succeed, then I just continue on. I do the second run, which I take a bit more seriously, and usually have more of a game plan. Usually if my initial game plan didn't work out, I just kind of change it and adapt it as I go. And then from there, I usually give myself 3 failures before I just switch tasks altogether. And when I say 3 failures, I don't mean like 3 silly failures. Like, as I was walking out of a door, I don't know, that's a bad example. So, like, if I just got a really bad spawn on a map, and it was something that was extraordinarily difficult to deal with, and I just get caught in a situation where I couldn't really do anything otherwise, even though that doesn't happen super often, it does happen on occasions. So if I fail in that way, I don't feel like it was, it was probably a preventative failure on my part, meaning I could have, maybe not put myself in that situation, or I could have got luckier and not got that spawn. But usually if I fail just by doing something stupid, you know, trying to rush things, or just not properly taking my time, or checking my corners, which is especially important when you're doing a stealth in this fashion, just because it's so easy to be detected. Especially on accident, if you're not really aware of your surroundings and what's going on. You know, usually if you're just rocking minimum detection, you can just kind of sprint all over the map and run, duck, and do all sorts of crazy things. And really just act like an idiot and still get away with stealth and be pretty good at it. And there's nothing wrong with that. I mean, it's effective, it's quick, and it works. However, you have to be a bit more methodical when you're doing stealth like this. Just because you're slower and not as much leeway for error, I guess, is the best way to put it. Anyway, long story short, this heist was, I think this was my second attempt at this, the first attempt. I screwed up pretty bad, because I got detected in a silly fashion, and I got myself in a sticky situation. And then I restarted and just kind of, maybe this was my third attempt. Yeah, because my second attempt was really short, because I got detected within, like, really early on, like a minute and a half, because I got seen as I was jumping up onto the roof. A murky water guard came out of the, came from the second floor onto the roof and just detected me as I was jumping over the railing. And so I just went ahead and restarted that because I didn't feel like dealing with it. One of the other stealth heists I've been working on for this is the Alesso heist. I've actually gotten extremely close to completing it several times now, actually. So that was originally supposed to be the second one of these I finished with completion before I just kind of took a break from it and decided to try this one out. The hardest part about the Alesso Heist is it's extremely structured and formulaic, quite different from framing frame, because day three framing frame is, you know, just such a mess of RNG. There's so many things I can change. The location of the vault changes, location of the devices change, and there's different things like location of the cameras and blah 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 blah. Whereas in Alesso Heist, there's less variability. Even though, like, the doors can spawn in different places, you're probably going to have to go through all of the kitchens anyway in order to unlock the doors. You pretty much pass by every single door on your route to get to the upper parts of the venue in that heist anyway. So it's not really going out of your way. Whereas in Framing Frame, if all of your devices are in, you know, the big music room down at the bottom, you know, you can risk exposing yourself because guards, of course, will see you all the way across the room and guards will see you from the upper floor. Whereas if you get all of them, like, close to the bedroom, or you get some in the kitchen and then you get some in the computer room and different things like that, it's just a lot easier. Regardless, they're just two different heists. But the hardest part about the Alesso heist consistently has been not getting to the pyrotechnics booth. Getting to the pyrotechnics booth is actually pretty simple. It's been getting from the pyrotechnics booth back down to the basement, which is the problem. It's the little area right after you leave the booth and you're walking through the little Hall of Fame display hall where it has, like, some sports memorabilia. That room in there is where my best runs have all failed. And if it hasn't been there, then it's been in some other ridiculous way, way earlier in the heist. Regardless, that's enough about videos I've already done and videos I plan on doing. So now that the bag moving section is finally finished, and I've got all 12 of the bags that I need to complete the heist, it was time to go back and get the artifact, secure my 13th bag. Thankfully, there wasn't anybody around here to detect me as I was going back to the top floor. So I had a pretty easy path back. I don't even think there were any guards up here as I was going to get the artifact, so I was just able to pluck it right up and go about my business. And since it's an artifact, I decided to go ahead and take it all the way to the van anyway. I might do a rework of this run in the future where I attempt to go for all bags. What I would really like to do at some point is try to get all loot, except I might use assets on that run, because it'll be so luck dependent to get the samurai armor without having the a closer bag spawn, or a closer, not a bag spawn, bag secure location. So, I might use assets for that run in particular, but if it's an all-loot run, it would be kind of different. I'd probably change some things up about it. I'd probably still do ICTV and 75 detection, but I might use, like, I don't know, RPG and a minigun, or just something different, you know. Just give it a bit more flavor than this, instead of just being a rehash and getting all-loot and using assets. This heist, I think I discussed this in the level 0 run of this heist. This heist doesn't suffer from lack of assets. This heist has only benefited from assets. So, for example, in other heists, you would be greatly hindered if you didn't buy assets. In such a way that I can't think of any directly off the top of my head. But some heists just become excruciatingly more painful and difficult without certain assets. However, this heist, the assets aren't really there to be a blockage for, you know, of course there are more optimal ways to do this heist with assets. That's absolutely not what I'm saying. What I am saying, though, is that if you don't have assets on this heist, it is still entirely doable and still pretty easy. And I do still think that's because of just the overall great design of this heist as a stealth heist. So I got this one money bag. Of course, I wasn't going to run across the yard to try to get that other bag. Or to, not to get the other bag. To check the other containers, I'm going to loop around the back. Or try to loop around the back. What I did right here, though, was I went ahead and checked the... went to check and see if that guard had moved from his position earlier, where he was looking at the two crates, the one at the forklift and the one in front of the truck. So we run over here just to see. However, as I'm going over there, this guy detects me. Instead of dealing with it, I just lay down the jammer, call it a day. Was that a really dumb move on my part? Yes, probably. I probably shouldn't have tried to just sprint across there like that. However, I knew I had the ECM jammer, and if I needed to, I could get away. Threw the grenade for literally no reason. And that was pretty much all there is to it. I got out with 13 bags, not a bunch. I could have got more. I'll probably try doing this again in the future to get a better run. However, that was my solo stealth ICTV 75 detection. Saw only no assets running for Shatterade. Thank you guys so much for watching.